Our hero did not dispute where he was. He disputed your rule book. Again, this judge is using a tactic of not answering the question. He's answering the question that he wishes our hero would have asked.
Choose, but this is, if you want to have the court...
Notice how stumbly he's being. Anytime you get a judge like that, you know you're being effective.
Appoint an attorney, let's settle that first. If you don't, then your choices today are either to...
Oh, he's going to say, okay, let's settle on the attorney matter. If you don't, then your choices today are... He's going to dictate what his choices are. This is where I really want to drop an FU. I'm going to try to do this without swearing as much as possible.
Participate in the community court program. I know you've been waiting patiently and heard me talk to other folks about
rights and options that they have. Okay, he's already moved on to giving him options. Well, you can do this community court, or you can do this, or you can do this, or you can do this. Completely ignoring the fact that you have no right to tell me what my options are or even dictate here in the first place at all because you don't have evidence of jurisdiction. The prosecution, that is, why aren't you asking him for it? Because you're not the one that's supposed to be trying to supply it. Why are you wearing two hats? Are you a judge or a prosecutor? Mr. Prosecutor, have you submitted any evidence of jurisdiction? Because that's the only thing I don't have a copy of right now. And that would satisfy the cause and nature of the charges and proceedings so that I could plead guilty, pay the fine, and get the fuck out. Oops, I swore.
There's a community court type offer. I don't know exactly what the agreement is in your case. If you don't feel like you're you're comfortable evaluating the plea agreement without...
If you don't feel like you're comfortable evaluating the plea agreement without an attorney... Nobody ever said that. That's not even relevant. Again, going off in the bushes.
...the assistance of an attorney, then maybe we should revisit that.
So now he's trying to say, if you don't believe in jurisdiction, maybe we should settle the issue of getting you an attorney.
Situation.
Because I'm not doing a good job of manipulating you, and maybe that attorney will. It's all about wearing you down, getting you frustrated, tired, depressed, shamed, humiliated, and broke. Then you'll bend the knee.
What would you object to? The information I'm providing?
No, not the information that you're providing, fool. You little liar. He's objecting to the information that you're putting on the transcript, and if he stands there in silence, that's acquiescence. If you just stand there in silence, then you must agree with what's said on the transcript, otherwise you would speak up. That's what objections are for. That's why judges get pissed off when you interrupt them with objections, point of clarifications.
Well, I feel like you haven't responded to allowing me to be informed as to the cause of this hearing. I'm trying to determine why I'm here in the first place.
Bam! Our hero ignores the judge's attempts at manipulation and distraction and to get him to abandon his relevant matter and brings it right back to the relevant matter.
With the crime that is alleged to occur here in Oklahoma County.
Thank you for stating the obvious, dummy. Ugh, Captain Obvious here.
And that's in the state of Oregon, and so it's subject to the Oregon Criminal Code, and that's why. I don't know what else to tell you.
Well, I don't know what else to tell you. You could tell me that you're going to make the prosecutor be held to his burden of prosecution and ask him for a copy of the jurisdiction. That's what you could do, objection, point of clarification.
Well, I don't know what to tell you. The judge is saying he's just out of options. Sorry, I can't do it. I'm not...
Oh, man. Whatever, buddy.
Point of clarification, is it not your opinion that my physical location would give jurisdiction in this matter? And are you...
I couldn't do better than all of these lines myself, man. Right back to the meat and potatoes. Beautiful.
This court has jurisdiction, yeah.
You are assuming jurisdiction. You didn't answer his question. You just proved his point. You're assuming it without evidence.
That's over me.
Right.
You're saying you have jurisdiction over me? The judge is like, right. The judge knows he's lying, and now he's just trying to, like, not even hide it. Let's try the tactic of just go through with it. See how he responds if I just admit it. Let's see what happens. If I start going there, what's this guy's response going to be? Another way the judge is probing to find the weakness. So far, he hasn't found a single one. He's probing, probing, probing with all of his tactics, probing, probing, and not a single weakness. So he's still probing. If he had found one, he would just be pushing that button, pushing that button, pushing that button. but he can't. All the arrows he's shooting, our hero has a shield for. It's beautiful.
And what other things are you relying on to support that plan?
That you're charged with a crime, alleged to have occurred in the middle of the town and here in the state of the world.
The hero just asked, what evidence are you relying on to determine that you have jurisdiction? And the judge's answer was, well, we've accused you of something. And I'm not going to go back and forth with you, because you're getting your ass handed to you on a silver platter. Jesus Christ.
If you want to speak with an attorney about some aspect of that,
can we please speak to an attorney so he can further manipulate you, because I'm not having any success, you're kicking my ass.
You're welcome to do so, either to hire your own or I would appoint a lawyer to...
It's not relevant. We haven't even been talking about that. Don't even go there. It's not on the table. This is just a worthless distraction.
Here's what, under the jurisdictional part, this court, based on these charges that are pending against you, you really have three big decisions that only you can make.
Alright. Now he's going to dictate more. He's totally abandoned answering about the jurisdictional issue, and that he's assuming it with no evidence.
And decision number one is to...
Now he's not calling them options. Now he's calling them, you've got three decisions to make. It's just a nicer word to try and force the same thing.
Resolve this case without a trial.
Now he's calling accepting a plea deal... Resolving this case without a trial is making things try and sound nice.
And that ordinarily is a function of a plea agreement that itself is composed of what would I be convicted of if I entered this plea agreement, what would go on my record, and what would the state recommend for my sentence
if
I participate in this plea agreement.
Blah, blah, blah.
What would be the end result?
Objection, point of clarification. Judge, I don't need to speak about all of these three decisions you're saying. I just need you to tell me that you're not going to presume jurisdiction here without evidence of jurisdiction. I need you to please hold the prosecutor to the burden of prosecution, and let's ask him about a copy of evidence of jurisdiction. How about that?
Other option, if you don't want to resolve the case without a trial, is to schedule the matter for trial. And that could be either a jury trial, you'd be entitled to...
Did he just say if you want to do it without a trial, schedule the matter for a trial? And that could be either a jury trial or a judge trial, bench trial? Maybe I heard that wrong, but...
A six-person jury?
A six-person jury, not a 12? Go F yourself. I want 12. Your own little stupid rules mention six. There's no mention of six in the original documents that you claim to respect. 12, bitch. 12. Never six.
That jury would have to be unanimous that the state had proved each of these charges beyond a reasonable doubt, the highest standard we have under the law. You could also have a trial without a jury, with just a judge, but only you could decide that, whether your trial was with a jury or a judge. Either way, though, if you did decide you wanted to have a trial to contest these cases...
Keep in mind, they'll never let this case go to a jury. They'll never let this case go to a jury. So the judge, and he knows it, so he's throwing it out there like it's one of his decisions. But it's not.
These charges?
Is a jury trial even possible? They'll just refile the charges, whether he accepts this like they did this to me. Whether you accept the plea deal or not, I told them to go F themselves with their plea deal of zero fine, zero jail, and zero community service. Right? I told them to F themselves and stop submitting them to me. So what'd they do? Refile the charges. Chopped all the maximum penalties away down to 30 days and a $1,000 fine. That way a jury trial isn't even possible. And these people are plenty happy with a $1,000 fine and a 30-day jail threat. So there's no way they're going to even let a jury be a possibility, but they'll sure as hell waste a bunch of hearings and a bunch of time trying to get that, well, until it finally has to come out that they have to divulge the information to the quote-unquote defendant that that's what they're doing. So it's just a time-wasting tactic.
Whether you chose to have a jury or chose to let a judge hear the testimony and consider the evidence, you could testify if you wanted to, and only you...
Blah, 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 blah. I don't need to know all of this. This is irrelevant. See, if you let a judge go on like this, this is blah, 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 blah. Next thing you know, 20 minutes go by, and then he turns back and says, look, you've kept me here for 20 minutes, and da, 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 da. And he's the one that's been blabbing most all the time, most all of the time of that 20 minutes. Okay? So we can't let him go blah, 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 like this on and on. We got an objection, point of clarification. Just so you know, Judge, all of this information, while I appreciate it, is not helping me make a decision because it's irrelevant to the issue at hand on the table here, which is, has the prosecutor met his burden of prosecution by submitting a copy of the evidence of jurisdiction? I don't have it. Can you please ask him for it, yes or no? Just some way to return it right back on there, because this is a waste of time.
You could make that decision.
Of course, you got to call it how you see it in the moment. You don't really want to like get super aggressive and piss a judge off when he's being nice and polite. Until he flips the switch, he or she flips the switch to be aggressive, you really don't have to. It's kind of better to be Columbo and Socrates and play the nice card. So play it by ear. Always try and keep it chill. Maybe I'll try and give some suggestions right now as to what I'd actually say in court to do that.
Here goes. No one could prevent you from testifying if you
want. If the hero doesn't do it, that is. I mean, so many times he just does it better than I could probably.
And by the same token, no one could force you to testify if you didn't want to. If you were representing yourself, there would be some other decisions you might want to consider, and that is, you know, what motions to file and arguments to make, either to the court or to the jury,
blah, blah,
to testify the case. But
blah, blah,
at the outset, before the matter is scheduled for trial, whether it's with a jury or a judge.
You haven't even got me arraigned yet. By your own admission, and you're trying to work on lawyers, and now you're trying to work on a decision for a trial? Why are you talking about trial? Objection, point of clarification. I would like to plead guilty and avoid a trial if I can once I get clarification of the cause and nature of the proceeding, specifically evidence of jurisdiction. Has the prosecutor submitted a copy of it yet? Because I don't have one. Yes or no? All irrelevant mumbo-jumbo this judge is going on for well over a minute or two now.
The determination to be made here is, first, do you want to resolve it without a trial? And if so, maybe even ahead of that.
I've already stated that. My intention is to plead guilty here. This judge is just, you know, you can't let him do this. You can't let him do this. He's being circular. He's wasting time. He's wasting time. Now he knows I'm not going to be able to do it. I'm not going to be able to force an attorney on him. I'm not going to be able to get him to agree to a plea. So now I'm going to stall, and then grant an extension. It's probably what he's thinking right now.
That's why it's something that is sort of considered at arraignment. Do you wish to be represented by an attorney? And if you can't afford one, or if you qualify for a court-appointed counsel, and in this case I'm understanding you would, the court could appoint an attorney to represent you and give you advice on those things. But only you could make those decisions. Your attorney could say, I think you.
Okay, objection, point of clarification. I choose not to make any decisions on anything that you've spoken about in the last couple minutes, and although I appreciate the information, I would like to know if the evidence has been submitted by the prosecutor to the element of jurisdiction to satisfy that. Do you have a copy of it? Because I don't. May I have a copy of the evidence of the jurisdiction, please, yes or no? Is evidence being hidden from me? Are you keeping secrets from me? I mean, this is eventually where it would go if they just keep pushing, but right now, of course, we're trying to be nice. We're trying to be nice.
I think that evening, that you participate in the community court program, and you can say thank you for your advice. I appreciate it, but I'm not going to do it. It's up to me. By the same token, if you set it for trial.
I don't know what their community courts are all about, but blah, 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 blah.
And your attorney said, no, I think this would be a good case for a jury. You can say thanks for your advice, but that's up to me. I want to waive my right to a jury and let a judge hear the testimony and consider the evidence, or vice versa. I might advise you to waive jury and let a judge decide it. You can say, no, I want a jury. Same with the testimony.
It's just wasting time. He is wasting time. You have got to object with a point of clarification and get it back on. Don't let him waste your time.
You could decide to testify, maybe your lawyer would.
All you need to do is objection, point of clarification. Judge, I do appreciate that you're telling me all this information. I really do, because I know you have people who don't know this information. However, I am aware of all of the information that you have said over the last couple minutes, and I'm simply asking to be allowed to plead an informed plea of guilty here after I see the evidence of jurisdiction that's been submitted by this prosecution to meet the burden of the prosecution. Can I please have a copy of the jurisdiction, yes or no? That would get it right back on point. But of course, anytime you do that effectively, even super nice, judge is going to get pissed anyway, because you're beating him at his own game. It's a beautiful thing.